using a bunch of chain hooked together to actually carry something somewhere. And they will change.
And change, because we have two questions like that. There are two questions like that. So
and that's the reason they're there, so that you can differentiate, because you might only get one of them. And you know, if you're only going to guess which one it is, you've got only 50-50 chance. Think of them as two different scenarios. One is a drive chain, and one is a chain conveyor. What is the best set screw arrangement for maximum holding power? Set screws out. Who's next?
90 degrees from.
Okay, your choices were, though, didn't give you 90 degrees. It gave you 3 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 12 o'clock,
3, 6, 9, and 12. 12 and 9.
Yep.
What number was that?
94.
Then just 12 and 9.
Pardon me?
It's 12, just so I thought it's 3, 6, 12, and 9.
No, you only use two set screws.
Okay, okay.
You put one set screw over the key, and if it holds a key, it keeps a key with whatever it's holding, whether it be gear, sprocket, whatever. And 90 degrees from that, and it doesn't matter if you go to 3 o'clock or you go to 9 o'clock. If you're calling the key 12, you can go to one or the other. But a clock has got, and you may be confusing what we were talking about when we were packing a pump and putting in the. You would put it at 12, next one you put it at 3, next one you put it at 6. Don't get those confused, because set screw there's only two. When you're packing a pump, you're going to have multiples, and you just keep going around the clock. If there happens to be 6, you just keep going 90 degrees right around them. But for the set screw, again, read the question. You read it twice and you understand, it will come easier, you say. No. So even reading it twice, sometimes you right off the bat want to jump to a conclusion, thinking you know what it is, and yet it's not really the question that you think it is. Whoever's next, the signal for stop in rigging is?
The chest.
Hand flat.
Hand flat.
Right out to the side. What is the most likely cause for an unbalanced fan blade?
Dirt on the blade.
Dent.
Dirt.
So normally you take a fan blade apart, you'll always see they get a build up. If for whatever reason it's static and stuff sticks to them. And a lot of times to balance them, just take them apart, clean them, and start them up again, and all of a sudden all your unbalance has gone away. So you don't have to worry too much about them, but that's a
especially if they're around some kitchen exhaust and stuff, or fat and moisture and oils and that are in the air, come right into your intake.
Okay, somebody wrote a bunch of stuff in this one, I don't know what it is, so if one of you guys had this exam, I don't know. Somebody's done, and maybe it's just straight conversion from feet to something else. I don't know. But the question being, next question is, on a 30-inch diameter drum that is dead wrapped, the drum rotates 4 complete revolutions. What's the length of the cable? What length of the cable moves? That's one of the calculation ones that I don't know.
What number was it?
It's number 121.
You see that mark he's in that test, but I think that's not funny, did that. That'd be scrap paper or something.
Okay, so going back to that question, Number one, a dead wrap of a cable on a drum means it's on its first layer. So number one, you gotta know what they're telling you. So you have a drum. And you have your cable. And you have four complete wraps, and then it comes out and go somewhere to do some work somewhere, and the other one comes back and I'm back on here. So dead wrap number one means it's right on the drum. It's not like you filled it up and then it's up here and then there's another one here. Number one, dead wrap means it's right on the drum. So it's important to know what it means. Number one means that they're on the drum, so it's in contact with that drum surface. So if we want to know, again looking at the drum sideways, and we have our cable on it, so we've got some wraps on that drum. What do we want to know about the cable and the drum?
Circumference.
Exactly. So we want the circumference equals pi
times diameter.
So if this says we're on a 30-inch drum, 30-inch diameter drum,
give you 94.24.
The first thing we should do when we see a question like this is find out what the answers are in. And in this one, the answers are in feet. So it's going to want to, it wants to know how many feet. This cable, when you rotate this four times, how much cable's coming off? And when we pull it back four complete revolutions, how much cable's going to go on here? Okay? So feet. 30 inches. What's the difference right off the bat? So we want to take our 30 inches, divide it by 12, to see how many feet we have, which is 2.5 feet. Now this just saves us some calculations in trying to figure out going back. The less calculations you do, less opportunity there's going to be
to screw up.
Exactly. Less chance of error. So we've got this. We know our diameter. So now we want to find out this. So it's 3.1416 times 2.5. And that equals
7.85
feet. Right? So, when this rotates one revolution, we've got, it's going to pull off 7.85 feet. Other piece of information on here says we're going to go around here four complete revolutions. So now if I times that by four, I get
31.4.
The answers they give me are 47.1, 31.4, 94.2 and 19.6, so we would take this second one, which is 31.4.
That was almost there.
So does it make sense?
Yeah.
So it doesn't matter really when we were talking about how fast the double was going.
Yeah.
We just did the exact same thing here to see how much cable came off the drum. Because we know how much belt came off the drum, basically we're going to do the exactly same thing. You could ask this question in I don't know how many different applications. So again, just read the question and think about however the circumference is, but look at it and find out this will save you some calculation. Do this once, and then you just have to do this, and you're bang, it's all over. Sound good? Whoever's next, the construction level is used for. Doing foundation construction work, something like that.
Yeah.
Of course, construction level.
What number was that?
That was 123.
Yeah, let's see.
So construction level, they're going to shoot. You can shoot a laser beam up to 500 feet, and you can either use it to mark. The light will show up on a wall or something. But if you don't have a wall, it will also get picked up. There's two heads that will pick up and give you an audible alarm that says, yes.
I'm using the square up shaves and pulleys and whatever, gears and stuff.
Yeah, they're the small ones. So you can get a small one that will magnetically go on there and help you with alignment. Mm-hmm. These ones are really those pictures where you're just gonna see them on a construction. They remind me of the guys out on the side of the road. One guy will be standing there with a stick, and the other guy will be standing there with his sight line. Yeah. Well, basically, is doing the same thing as what all those surveyors were doing, but it's like used for construction and setting foundations and all the other sort of stuff.
That's an easy one to get away. Careful of those.
Okay, where is a vibration transducer placement on an enclosed electric motor? Answers are radial, vertical, axial, or all the positions.
I just guessed because I did not know the answer.
So let's look the answer up. If there's something running in the background above that or not, but man, this is never this slow.